all about the rider and the horse. There's a huge team behind, and every time we go to a competition, there is a whole bunch of people who are feeling butterflies, probably even more so than the riders, because we are not in control of what is going on. And being on the side of the arena is 10 times more nerve-wracking than being in charge of the horse itself.
Well, this is a rider who's not long out of the world's top 10, sits 19th on the world rankings at the moment, Lauren Nicholson. Lauren with Vermiculus, Bug as he's known, owned by Jackie Mars, by Caesarum, very closely related to Lauren's first five-star horse, Snooze Alarm. Lauren was an Olympian in Rio. She's been twice USEF national five-star champion and a Pan American Games gold medalist. Vermiculus has been top 10 at Kentucky and at Burley over in Great Britain at the five-star level. And still just 14. He's been a busy little horse in his career. Went to the World Games for the United States of America in 2018. So just a little bit of a bobble coming out of the first talk, Christian, but I was going to ask you, we've got quite a short approach to the end of the ring for them to enter a day, and it kind of hadn't occurred to me because I'm lucky enough to get to watch quite a lot of pure dressage and maybe indoors where we don't have the room to give them. Our eventers are used to having acres of space, so they've got to, when they came in here to familiarize and think about their preparation, they've probably all had to come up with a new plan for even getting into the ring.
Yes, you always have to decide, first of all, you know, which canter is best to come in. It's not prescribed which canter you have to use. But what you need to bear in mind in this arena specifically, you can see in the backdrop those kind of chalet, those kind of sponsors, sort of marquees. And these actually are quite noisy. We were surprised during the three-star how much noise was coming out of it. And that's very close to the arena, very close to the entrance. And for some horses, it might just have an impact and affect them as they're about to go down the center line. Very nice rhythmical trot. I like that line of this horse. You can see on the short side, it was really lovely and a nice forward connection. Here, the half pass is very smooth. You'd like a fraction more energy and a little bit more impulsion just to, again, make it more convincing. Now that she's on the circle, it looks a little bit better. And the half pass, you can see the horse is really upright. He's controlling his outside shoulder well. And straight away into a very relaxed walk. So we're not like in Grand Prix going from walk to Piaf or Piaf to walk, but it's still, for these ultra fit horses, it's a very big challenge to actually drop their neck and relax in the walk and use their whole body for high marks. Very good transition on that turn. You see there was absolutely no break in the rhythm. You can see from behind it's a good activity in the walk. There is no slowing down from the extension, which as a judge we are looking for. We want to see the same tempo, the same level of activity. And obviously in the medium walk it is challenging, especially when they come to this area here where normally they go into canter, or this time they have a halt. A lot of riders that you will see probably later might just try to slow down a little bit to keep the lid on their emotion of their horse. Here, Vermiculus is very confident, obviously very well trained, and you can see compared to Will Coleman, you know, I mentioned the fact he was a bit more deliberate in his strike off. Lauren, with a more experienced horse, was able to be much more direct, and that's where you gain the little half extra points here and there. It was a clean change. It was a little bit on the flat side. It was like when you go jumping, the flying changes are like jumping a big upright. You need to set the horse up and do your little half hold and then ride forward to it. In this instance, I felt Lauren was perhaps a little bit casual coming across the diagonal. I would have liked her to prepare that change a fraction more to get better expression. And here, little bugger, anticipated the change, and I don't think Lauren was quite in control of that one.
But again, going back to what we were saying earlier about riding the horse you're on, when she took that quite flat first change, it might have been because she knows he does tend to anticipate.
It might well be. It's very easy for us sitting here on a steady chair and having nothing else but just observe. But it's just, yeah. I think the problem with the change is when the horses know where they are coming, it can be quite difficult. And therefore in training, you really need to play with where you do them. Some horses, if they are a little bit sticky with the changes, you will repeat them exactly where you want them to be. With other horses, like him potentially, you will always try to do them at different spots so he doesn't know when they are coming and hopefully will wait for you to ask for them.
And again, it's that sort of mental bogey for the rider. We see it when, you know, when we've got four changes in the test, which we've had at the five-star level for several years, they build and build and build sometimes because, you know, if they're a hoodoo in the rider's brain, every time you're riding them, you're communicating that to the horse.
Absolutely. And as I said before, with Will Fawdry, you know, you do get tense, and if you know one change is more difficult or your horse is likely to anticipate, you will get tense yourself, which does not help.
Well, Bug Vermiculus gets a little scratch on the mane from Lauren. She knows his foibles at this stage. I think he'll still be allowed a treat of a banana after his dressage here.
From memory, he's part Arab and very closely or similarly bred to Tamarillo, who was also a little clown in the arena sometimes. So they have similar traits.
But Lauren, you know, she rides with such confidence. She knows that what she's doing when it's going right should be getting good marks, and she's riding for every single one of them.
Absolutely. And this walk is an example of it. I mean, it's very relaxed. It's forward, purposeful, and certainly would be deserving high marks. Yeah, so this flat change, you know, you can see as she got onto the diagonal, he just started to sort of gain ground on her and get a little bit out of balance. And as you say, you know, if she knows he's going to anticipate, she needs to go with him and slightly pay the price afterwards.
So we'll get Laura Nicholson's score in just a moment with Vermiculus, the first of her rides in the five-star here at Maryland. The Landmarks Monte Carlo as well coming up. There's David O'Connor in the background, whom Lauren's worked for a number of years. David, the 2000 Sydney Games individual gold medalist. And 30.7 comes in, so just again, we only have that one score below 30. It's Buck Davidson, our trailblazer, on 28.7. Lauren Nicholson and Vermiculus knocking on the door of 7.